Hello students, this is the next video. Probably in this video we'll be ending up this chapter, chemical reaction and equations. The last topic left is effects of oxidation. Now oxidation has some negative effects also, and here we are going to discuss two such effects, corrosion and rancidity, taking them one by one. First, corrosion. Corrosion is, you must have heard, ye corrode ho gaya, this has got spoiled. This is basically used for metal surfaces. When the quality of the metal surface deteriorates, as you have observed that during rainy season, your iron things kept outside, they get rusted. Rusting is one type of corrosion. So basically, when the quality of the metal degrades or the metal surface is eaten up due to air, moisture, or acid attack, etc., then such a process is called corrosion. So this is the definition of corrosion: when metals are attacked or eaten away by air, moisture, acid, etc., it is called corrosion. Now corrosion is also a chemical reaction, and as we did, it is about oxidation and combination with other substances. So when iron gets oxidized, it changes to, this is the formula of rust, it changes to iron oxide, which is reddish brown in color, as you observe rust. You all are very familiar with rust on the iron, which your otherwise in Hindi it is ki jang lag gaya. That jang is rust. So reddish brown color, this is due to the oxidation of the metal. Then silver also gets oxidized and changes into blackish color. You must have seen that silver articles generally change their color and become blackish. This is due to the formation of silver sulfide. This is due to the formation of silver sulfide as a result of oxidation of silver. Copper utensils, if you have at home, or any copper article, generally during the rainy season, it develops a greenish coating over itself. This greenish coating is also formed as a result of oxidation of the metal, and that greenish coating is called basic copper carbonate. Basic copper carbonate, this is the formula, CuOH whole twice dot CuCO3, and is greenish in color. So generally these are the articles which get oxidized, and these are the formulas of the oxidized product of them. We know that corrosion is an unwanted phenomena and results in the degradation in the quality of the metal. Therefore, it must be avoided and all measures should be taken to prevent corrosion. So what are the preventions for corrosion is, we can paint the metal surface so that it does not come in direct contact with air and moisture, etc., and hence the metal surface is protected, does not corrode. Similarly, we can do oiling, we can do greasing. These are basically to avoid the contact of the two. One more method is galvanization. Galvanization is coating the metal surface, iron with zinc. When we coat iron with zinc, it is called galvanization, and it prevents the corrosion of iron. We get GI pipes. You must have heard, we get iron pipes as GI pipes. These GI pipes are nothing but galvanized iron pipes because they do not rust and are generally used in the construction of buildings, etc. Then another method is alloying. What is alloying? Mixing of one metal with the other metal. When the metals are alloyed, they generally do not get corrode easily. For example, if iron is alloyed with other metals like chromium and all to form steel, we know that steel does not show rusting. And you must have also observed that when there is more content of iron in the steel, you see steel articles also rusting. Next, we have rancidity. Rancidity. Now, sometimes you must have seen that the food, some food articles, especially containing oil like namkeens, chips, oil-based food, when kept for a very long time, the smell of the food changes, the taste of the food changes. And in summer time, or in the, especially in the rainy season and very hot humid climate, the food also changes its taste and color or gets spoiled. This entire phenomena is actually called rancidity. So now let's come up here, rancidity. Fats and oils get oxidized and smell, color and taste of the food items change. When the oxidation of fats and oils takes place, their color, their taste and their smell also changes for a bad. Means it gets spoiled. And this phenomena is called rancidity. So actually what is bringing about rancidity is oxidation. It means oxidation of food should not take place because oxidation spoils the food, and hence we have the word antioxidants. Very commonly you have heard food rich in antioxidants, food rich in antioxidant. This has good antioxidant quality because antioxidants maintain the value of the food, maintain the properties, healthy properties of the food items. It means rancidity is an unwanted phenomena and hence it should be prevented. So here I have written some preventions of rancidity. First of all, the same word, we can add antioxidants to foods containing oil and fat. As a result, they will stay fresh for a much longer time. Then by packaging oil-based foods in nitrogen gas. You eat chips and all, crisps, very favorite of yours. You see that packet is much blown up and with some air. That air is actually not this atmospheric air, but that is nitrogen gas. And if you read on the packet, it is generally written nitrogen flushed. Because nitrogen is an inactive gas, it does not react. So as long as the food is flushed with nitrogen, no type of reaction takes place. There is no air in the food, so no oxidation takes place and the food keeps fresh for longer. This is a reasoning question also generally asked. Then by keeping the food in airtight containers, your mother keeps the food in tight airtight containers because it also prevents contact with oxygen and hence avoids oxidation of food or spoiling of food. Refrigerating the food items, if you lower the temperature, the oxidation reaction does not set up and hence the refrigerating the food items also protects the food. And then storing away from light. When light falls on your food, it gets spoiled earlier. So generally we place them in cool dark place. And it is written for medicines also, store in cool dark place. This is also to avoid oxidation or to avoid rancidity of the food. I hope this topic is clear to you and you are liking and enjoying studying with me. So please continue and we'll be moving on to the next chapter in the next video. Do share it and subscribe it definitely for the new uploads and share it with your friends also. Thank you.